So parent to parent, I'd like to give you some advice. These are things that I've struggled with and sometimes overcome, sometimes I don't. I'm still learning, and that's really the key. You are constantly a learning parent. As you know, how life was when your child was a baby is not the way it is today when your child is 5 or 10 or 15 years old. So I think it's important to embrace the changes that we are having, the changes that we're struggling with. We had no idea that this was going to happen. Like when 2020, like Happy New Year happened, no one knew that this was going to happen. So here are a few things I'd like to leave with you as we end this series. Number one is patience. Now, I'm not going to be high and mighty and be like, be patient to your child. But my advice is be patient with yourself. It's really hard. The place that you've been put is a really difficult place. It's challenging, especially if you're a single parent, especially if you are overwhelmed with a thousand things to do. If you're a stay-at-home mom, if you're a working mom trying to manage your child's schedules, these are all really tough times. We're all being stretched in ways that we never thought. Be patient with yourself. Cut yourself some slack. You will not be perfect all the time, and don't expect yourself to be perfect. No one is perfect. I may look like I'm perfect right now, but I've spent 5 minutes putting makeup on and making myself perfect. I do not have the answers. You don't have the answers. We all don't have the answers, but we can all share in resources and help each other. And that's actually what I'm my friend Akshita told me to that this would be a really good topic to talk about. Because I think all of us are in the same boat where we want to help each other. Resources like Pinterest and Teachers Pay Teachers and Scholastic, they're really good resources which are free. Some of it is free, some of it is not. But use those resources to help you, empower you as a parent. It's really important. But more than anything, be patient with yourself. The second thing is forgive yourself. Just like in case you lose your patience, don't be guilty or don't feel like, oh, I'm such a horrible parent. Every parent feels like they're a horrible parent at least 5 times a day, okay? Even the most perfect parent who looks like they are perfect makes mistakes and feels bad. Forgive yourself. It's very important when you make mistakes to forgive yourself and, of course, ask for forgiveness. Another important thing is forgive your child. Your child is also struggling. Your child doesn't know what in the world is happening. They're putting on they're normally used to putting on a uniform and going to school and having individual teachers teach them each subject. It is a hard transition for them to have their parent teach them all their subjects. Your different roles can also be confusing for your child. So forgive your child for making mistakes. Your child may not match the standard that you have set in your mind. Let that go, because your child is totally different from you. The mistakes you made or the good that you did may not be the same path of your child. Your child may make a new path, a new way of writing. Like, for example, my husband has terrible handwriting. I have very nice handwriting. My daughter doesn't copy me or him. My daughter has her own unique style. So that is very important to acknowledge and see that you have to accept your child's uniqueness and forgive them for the mistakes that you think they are making. And of course, definitely accept their differences. Next is speak kindly to your children. I think it's very important to acknowledge that our children are intelligent. They're smart. They listen. But it's very important to speak in a way that is kind to them and understanding to them. Like I said, they have their own challenges. Kids are smarter than we realize, and they really imitate us. So if you become a supportive voice of encouragement, then they will follow suit and do the same in their life. So speak kindly and be encouraging, because that will really make your environment and your process much, much more positive. And finally, create a supporting and encouraging environment, which means using words like great job, amazing, you can do this, I believe in you. Using words like that can really uplift your child's heart and spirit. Like, I know that when I see something that my child has done, even in my worldly information that I think, oh, you know, the drawing is not perfect, but if I say, you know what, this is amazing, I really appreciate your effort, I appreciate the uniqueness you have brought to this drawing or this thing, that the child's, their whole spirit gets, I don't know, try it, experiment with it. Say something encouraging to your child and see their eyes light up, and you know, a smile, and it's almost like they're like a flower blooming. like in Tari Zameen Pe, there was a beautiful line, dialogue that Amir says about a tree, where if you curse that tree, the tree dies. But if you encourage that tree that and water it and love it and give sunshine, the tree grows. So similarly, when we encourage our children, regardless of what we feel, like, don't put your personal bias into anything. Your child is, like, remember their age. A 2-year-old cannot do what a 8-year-old is doing. A 5-year-old cannot do what a 10-year-old is doing. Understand their age. Understand what, where their limitations and their standards are. Understand you are also, like, I always tease myself that if when my daughter is 7, I am also a 7-year-old parent. When my daughter is 10, I will be a 10-year-old parent. You are as old as your child as a parent. So understand that about yourself and your child. So if you expect too much from your child, it's probably because you're expecting too much from yourself. So don't put that pressure on yourself or your child. The more easier we make life for ourselves, the better it is. I hope this has helped you. Definitely, if you have more questions, I would love to chat with you more. If you feel like this video is not enough, I think I've covered all corners. But if you feel like this video is not enough, let me know. I'm happy to do like a live session on this as well. Hope this has helped you and blessed you. And like I said earlier, there'll be resources that I'm posting down of apps and websites and the worksheet, the schedule worksheet that I'm giving away. I hope this transition into homeschooling is smooth and positive and can just make your life easier and more comfortable. Thanks for joining me, and I'll catch you in the next video.